Greetings, Father. Greetings, Mother. Munivar, how come you're here?
Ganesh, my son. Munivar is about to begin writing a book of holy scriptures, for which he is in need of someone smart and intelligent who can write as fast as he recites. I have a feeling that there is no one better than you for this task, my son.
As you command, Father. Shall we, Munivar?
Oh, yes. I'll take your leave, my lord.
My lord, why don't you tell him?
Munivar?
Yes?
I shall certainly help you write your book, but only on one condition.
What kind of condition could he have?
You will have to keep reciting non-stop as I write.
I see.
If you pause even to take a breath, Munivar, then I shall stop writing immediately.
Very well, son of Gauri. But I too have a condition for you. Whatever couplet I recite, you will write it down only after you understand it fully.
Only after I understand it?
Under this pretext, if I get tired, I shall give him a complicated couplet, which he will have to rack his brains to try and understand. During which time, I can pause for a nice deep breath.
I accept your condition. Well, what are you thinking about? Shall we begin?
Indeed, we shall begin, little Ganesh.
Yes, my lord. Here you go.
Continues, I'm never going to finish writing.
Ganesh, Ganesh, my son, this sacrifice of yours shall not go in vain.
Abhishek?
Yes, my lord. So the scriptures are finally done.
Here you are, Munivar. Your book is finally ready.
Ganesh ji, this book is a result of your own intelligence, diligence, and the sacrifice you have made. I cannot think of anyone else in the whole world who could have made this happen. Thank you, Ganesh ji. May you be blessed abundantly.
And that is how the renowned epic Mahabharata was written and compiled by Ganesh ji. So you see, besides being an